My dear student, now the another topic which is related to this chapter, molecular basis of inheritance, and which opens some of the fact regarding human being, and it was understood in a specific project that is known as Human Genome Project. Now, I want to discuss what is Human Genome Project and how it is helpful and what is its application. So, Human Genome Project was launched in the year 1990 and was completed in 2003. It was coordinated by the US Department of Energy and National Institute of Health, and during the early years the Wellcome Trust of UK became a major partner. Its aim was to isolate and determine the complete DNA sequence in humans. Knowledge about the effect of DNA variation can lead to revolutionary new ways to diagnose, treat, and someday prevent the thousands of genetic disorders. So one thing I want to clear, that what are the sequencing of DNA molecule which are blueprint of life, if we are not knowing about the number of genes which are present in any life, how we can regulate. So this project opened the fact how many genome, what is the level or what are the number of DNA molecule which are acting as a gene will be discussed here. Knowledge about other organisms' DNA sequence can also be applied towards solving challenges in health, agriculture, energy production, and environment. Many non-human model organisms such as bacteria, yeast, free-living non-pathogenic nematodes, Drosophila, plants, have also been sequenced and utilized for different purposes. So, relationship of Human Genome Project with bioinformatics. So, this DNA is very important and it is known as blueprint of life. So, now we discuss the human genome is said to be approximately 3×10⁻⁹ base pair. The cost of sequencing required is estimated at $3 per base pair, which means that the total estimated cost of the project would be approximately $9 billion. Now, the obtained sequences, if stored in type form in books, would require 3,300 books, each book containing 1,000 pages to store the information of DNA sequence from a single human cell. Just to remind you, to store such enormous amount of data necessitated the use of high-speed computational devices for data storage, retrieval and analysis, an area in the biology called as bioinformatics. So lot of information coming about the life that is deep by the bio of Socrates. So now we discuss about the methods to identify the genes. The method involve two major approaches. One approach is focused on identifying all the genes that express as RNA, referred to as express sequences. The other approach called sequence innovation involve simply sequencing the whole set of genome that contain all the coding and non-coding sequences and later assigning different region in the sequence with the function. Now this is the picture of a genome. Now what is genome sequencing? For sequencing, the total DNA from a cell is isolated and converted to random fragments of relatively smaller sizes and cloned in suitable host using a specialized vector. The cloning results into amplification of each piece of DNA fragment so that it is subsequently sequenced with very easily. Now commonly used host in human genome project where bacteria and yeast and the vector where BAC, that is bacterial artificial chromosome, and YAC, yeast artificial chromosome. So both the vector has been shown in the figure, and this is yeast artificial vector which are present here, and there is a bacterial artificial chromosome vector, and they are very much utilized for that purpose. The fragments are sequenced using automated DNA sequencer known as Sanger sequencing machine. These sequences are then arranged based on the overlapping regions present in them. This alignment is done using a specialized computer-based program. This is all about the methodology, and these sequences are subsequently annotated and are assigned to each chromosome. Now, how we prepare the genetic and physical map of the genome? After all of the human chromosome were sequenced, another challenging task was assigning the genetic and physical map on the genome. This was generated by two methods using information on polymorphism of restriction endonuclease recognition site. So this restriction endonuclease in an enzyme which cut the DNA molecule at specific places using some repetitive DNA sequence known as microsatellites. So observation from human genome project. So what we are going to gather the information, the human genome contains 3,164.7 million nucleotide bases. The average gene consists of 3,000 bases, but sizes vary greatly, with the largest known human gene being dystrophin at 2.4 million bases. The total number of genes is estimated at 30,000. Almost all 99.9% nucleotide bases are exactly the same in all people. So this is very important. only 0.1% had the differences, and this important characteristics have been taken to develop the DNA fingerprint. The function are unknown for over 50% of the discovered gene. Still, less than 2% of the genome codes for proteins. Repeated sequences make up very large portion of the human genome. The repeated sequences are stages of DNA sequences that have no direct coding function, but they shed light on chromosome structure, dynamics, and evolution. Chromosome has most gene 2,986, and the Y, this is X, and the Y has the fewest, that is 231. The scientists have identified about 1.4 million locations where single nucleotide polymorphism occur in humans. This may evolutionize the process of finding chromosomal location for disease associated sequences and tracing the human history. So this is all and how the human gene project is very much helpful for our future, for our health, for benefit get from all these genes in every aspect of our